After I showed you BlackBerry Droid for PC and laptops, x86 64-bit, I must as well create a 32-bit, but that one will come very soon. I today want to bring you as well BlackBerry Droid, but then for phones, okay? In, I think, 2022, BlackBerry will, you know, quit with all the phones, etc. And then we won't be having no BlackBerry phones anymore. So, you know, yeah, BlackBerry Playbook as well is now kind of, you know, history. Although I see that the market is still open, you can still log in with your account. So there at BlackBerry, they are very, very nice, you know, to the users. Microsoft can learn from that, really. I'm telling you, Microsoft. I mean, their store is still open, and it was announced to be closed, you know, at the end of 2019. So that's, you know, how BlackBerry is. So that's why, you know, I love the company. I have a bunch of BlackBerry phones as well, you know, complete collection that I'm gonna show you one of these days. But today is about BlackBerry Droid for phones. Now, I will not be able to bring it to all phones, but at least every phone with a TWRP custom recovery running Android 5 to 9 will be able to install the mod. So you will still have the same thing, you know, permanent. And for the phones that I have, I'm gonna make a complete collection, you know, and I started with the Note 3, the N9005. This will not be for the core and for the other models. You guys, you will have to flash the mod, okay? However, I created a very lovely system for my N9005, that is the HLTE. And I did it on E, so it's called eBBOS, eBlackberry OS, you know, could be that BlackBerry as well could receive in real life firmware from E, because E is as well creating firmware for the Fairphone. So why not for BlackBerry, right? So I started with planting a seed. The seed is here in my hands. Well, the plant was, you know, the seed was planted some days ago already when I showed you the x86 version. But today it's about the version for the Note 3. It's one lovely black phone, BlackBerry. And yeah, it's not BlackBerry. BlackBerry has nothing to do with this. I'm just, you know, these are my friends, and you know, we keep the name up, okay? We don't want things to die out there. Even though they decided to stop, we're gonna continue because we are the fans of and friends of BlackBerry as well. So what is it? It's of course official firmware from E Foundation that I dressed and modified and repacked again. So all credits for the engine goes to E Foundation, all right? And it became a very lovely system that will give you a duo BlackBerry UI phone in one. This is very special ROM, okay? The modders will as well, depending on what kind of ROM they're gonna flash it on top to. I think that Lineage OS is a fine ROM, you know, and as well supported for many phones. So many people will be able to download this BlackBerry mod that I especially created for you guys and girls out there. So let me not talk too long. Welcome again to Channel 48. My name is Puck, and thank you for tuning in again. Welcome back. The file is copied to the phone, and we just gonna reboot the phone and do a simple wipe. Okay, I advise you, if you're gonna install this ROM on the Note N9005, first go to EROM, get the official ROM, and first install it. Okay, make sure that you first install it to see if everything works, and then install my ROM. Okay, so what you're gonna do is, if you installed eFoundation ROM onto the phone and everything worked for you, you're kind of satisfied, you come back, you go into recovery, and you do a normal wipe. Then you go back home and then you're gonna find the ROM. It's called BlackBerry Droid V1 for only the 9005. I don't have these other models, so you guys can just flash EROM and then you flash the mod. Okay? So now we're gonna go ahead and... Or you can as well flash LinuxOS. It depends on what you want to flash. It's all up to you. Okay? We first gonna flash the ROM and then we're gonna flash a mod on another phone that as well runs eFoundation ROM, and then you're gonna see how it works, okay? We're looking at the real-time install. There we are, we're almost there, flashing the kernel. Okay, do a little wipe data catch and then reboot last system. And then wait for it. Might take a bit to boot, okay. There we go, booting started. And the boot up time is about, I did not measure it yet, you know. So we can just let it boot to see how it's gonna go. It boots just the same way as the Android x86. It's just the same, at least the same look and feels. Okay, trying to get the blue here. I want to show you the nice little blue. You see that blue there? Looks really nice. Just set the screen a bit darker for you out there. And we should arrive anytime from now. Bring the phone a little bit closer. Skip, start. You're gonna see two launchers. The Bliss launcher and the Nova launcher. If you're gonna hit the Bliss launcher, just once, then it's gonna load for you. And there you are, the Bliss launcher, but now with BlackBerry icons, and this is horizontal sliding. It's kind of iOS styled, you see that? Very nice, including the beautiful Mi Control Center that you must set up. Big up to Jack Reddit for pointing me to this amazing, beautiful Control Center that I really like, and I think it fits good, you see that, with the system. So if you're gonna slide down from the right side, you're gonna get to the Control Center, and if you're gonna slide down from the left side, the left side, then you're gonna get, don't you do that, hold on, let's go. Anyway, you just slide to the right here, and then you can see the USB device is charging, and then from here you can go to transfer files to your computer. Okay, so now you have an amazing, beautiful control center. You can change these colors as well. You know, this one is nice, orange and Bluetooth. That one's a little bit stubbish at this moment. It's still setting up, but this is how it looks. You have some great applications. Oh yeah, by the way, you as well have the Nova launcher. And in there, you will have to fix things. This you can set up completely the way you want. Look and feel, for instance. Scroll speed, no, I'm fine with that. Icon style, icon theme. You select the BlackBerry icon pack, adaptive icons, reshape legacy icons, and here go to customize and set everything to 20%. I'm just showing you how to set it up so you're gonna get this great look and feels that you saw in my video as well.
Okay, so then effect we're done. And now we can go back. And screen orientation, you see that? You can as well force landscape. So for tablets, this is as well very nice. App drawer. The app drawer, you set transparency to 73%. And then, that all is good. Go back to the icons. Icon layout, make sure that this is set to white. Okay, so now we're gonna be having, let's put it for always. Now we're gonna be having a nice, lovely dark background as well with the BlackBerry logo nice there in the home screen. This must be removed, this is ridiculous. And these things as well, remove. The phone goes here, centered with the system settings app. This one must be how to remove. Remove. Okay, and then we're gonna go here. And then you're gonna see that the messaging app has a green icon. We don't want that. We want, of course, in the icon pack, we choose for this BlackBerry messaging icon that we're gonna put here. So this is the setup. Okay, long press, go to widgets and grab the Nova action, set it there, give it the app drawer function, long press, edit, hit the icon, go to the icon pack and select the white drawer. Okay, you see that? Now you're not done with the desktop yet. We're gonna go to widgets one more time, scroll all the way down. Here I have a beautiful clock for you that you can put there. Later, long press, resize, make it a little bit bigger. This thing is so beautiful. Set it nice in the middle and you're gonna have a nice clock that when tapping on it, you can as well make it semi-transparent. You can say, I don't want dark color. Let's see what we have now. Now you're gonna have another beautiful stylish clock. If you don't like the green, you go to the clock and then you go here to color and you set it to blue, there. Then it corresponds with your, you know, with the blue here. So yeah, as you can see, this is Nougat, but it looks amazingly beautiful. And thanks to the beautiful control center and the pimped pull-down menu, it looks just beautiful. It just looks like wow. At least, I think so. Okay, hit the back button if you want to let it go up again. Because if you pull it down too much, it can go sit there. But most of the times it will sit good. Okay, you have some applications on board. Let me go through them. Weather wallpapers, this extended wallpaper app, of course, via browser. You have Telegram, you have tasks, settings, scanner radio, Russian TV, for my Russian friends this time, recorder, radio droid, PRTX for my amateur friends, power amp to listen to high quality music, your phone, of course, PDF viewer, open keychain, I don't know what it is, Nova settings, notes, new pipe for our YouTube, music, micro G settings, we have micro G on board, the Mi control that we just set at top, messages, mail, Magic Earth, you have navigation on board, but probably you will have to update this app because I'm not sure if this app is still being accepted by Magic Earth because they updated and the cards are not compatible, so you will have to go into Aurora store whenever they are online. Again, they are offline now for updating. We have Flipboard that you will have to update in the Aurora store as well. Okay, update it and it will work. It's crashing at this moment. But after update, it will be just fine. Firefox Lite as well. Beautiful browser. Micro G has stopped. I don't know what it is. Oh, yeah, we are not connected to the internet. That's why. Open camera. Of course, it works very good. It's a very good camera. It works fine. Trust me. We have ARD MediaTek and Artel. This is for watching live TV and series, German series, for those who like it. I like it, so it's always in there. The e-browser and the e-store. We as well have the e-store, so that you have, effect, two stores. And because the system has micro-G built in, big chance that applications, even NPO, works on this system. So yeah, that is it. I hope you like it. So let's go ahead and flash the mod to the Note 2 and see how that looks. Okay, we now arrived at the Note 2. I'm copying the ROM to the phone. Okay, and now we're gonna just go ahead and reboot la telephone. Hey, come on, reboot, man. Reboot. Yes. I'm gonna start with holding up volume. Pressing home. And now volume up, home power, and we let go when we see the logo for a second or so. And this should bring us into Twerp. And we're gonna do a normal wipe. And then we're gonna install EROM. This is as well the latest build from December by eFoundation, but this could as well be any version of any ROM, Android 5 up to Android 9, okay? So if you have any phone that has Twerp recovery installed, I think as well on KitKat should as well work, but it's kind of sensitive, KitKat. Might crash, I never test. But Android 5 up to Android 9, you will be able to flash the mod on top of those ROMs. Not Android 10, because that won't work. The first builds of Android 10 would accept the mod, but then the file system was changed. And we got two systems, NSS and a vendor product. And locations of these applications were changed. Okay, we do a wipe catch Dalvik, and we now gonna install the mod, the BBOS mod, installing system apps. Thank you for installing Pugrom 2020. I must update that line. And now wipe catch Dalvik once again. And now we're gonna reboot. And now we should have the same thing. I hope that all went right. There we go. Boot animation is a bit bigger on this phone, but that's of course because of the resolution. So we're gonna log in with the Note 2. So you're gonna have two files, a ROM and a mod. Okay, a mod is not a ROM. A mod is an add-on to a ROM. Remember it. So don't flash only the mod, because it won't work. So if you're gonna go for the Nova launcher, always, we're gonna get into exactly the same that I showed you. We go to settings, and we go to look and feel, icon style, icon theme, of course, the BlackBerry icon pack. We set this one on again. We customize, we set everything to 20%. And then we have the right corners. You still want the thing to look good, right? I mean, like, if you can, you should take advantage out of that. So we set this to always on, etc., etc. Look, man, this is one beautiful, beautiful phone. Delete, remove, remove, and there, one more, remove. This one goes here. And this one here, we're gonna change to the one from BlackBerry. This one here. You can as well go for the yellow one if you want. I think the yellow one was as well nice. In the X86 system, I used the yellow one. We as well have Firefox built in. So, but yeah, I must test all these apps if they all work good. We of course have Micro G as well built in. Okay, this one goes there. Widgets, this one here. Boom. Make it the app drawer. Edit. The BB icon, the white one. You see that? Boom. Lovely. This thing go away. And we go grab our clock. All the way here. Let's grab this one. We have the right size. Later, boom. There we go. Nice. And of course the wallpaper. Yeah. You must go find a wallpaper, BlackBerry wallpaper, you know. I'm gonna set it to black. Then, vote. Nice. You see that? Maybe the clock is a little bit too big. Resize like that. And then dark theme would look nice. Color I would set to red. Red. Did I set red? Yes. And I go back. You see? Nice clock that you can set up exactly the way you want. Okay, now I want to see one more thing. Is my control center working? Yes, it is working just fine. Beautiful. Let's turn it on. Mi control on. Mi control. And this one we as well turn on. Okay, yes, fine, I agree. No, thank you. So this side will give the normal pull-down menu, and this one will give you the control center. Okay, that all works nice. And this is it. Two of the same phones. Oh yeah, wait a minute, we forgot something. This looks ugly, man, hold on. Settings, app drawer. Set this one to 64%. Like that. Now it looks good. Now it looks outstanding. Hey, wait a minute. It still doesn't look good. Hold on. We're gonna put it more. App drawer. 87%. Let me see. Oh, wait a minute. I know why it's not looking good. Settings. App drawer. No, go back. Home screen. Damn it. One back. Icons, of course. Here. Okay, it's already set to white. You see the color? That's why it did not look good. Here. Now it's gonna be fine. You see that? So this is the mod. And the mod and the ROM, they give kind of the same look and feels to the device. Oh yeah, we set the clock to white. This clock looks different. I have no idea why. Use second hand. Maybe it's that one. Let me see what kind of settings I have in here. Done. This one is on. Oh, this one is off. Okay. And then background is on, off, off, and off. Now we should have the same clocks. Yeah, look at that, peeps. Hey, what you say? Hey, what you say, peeps? Is this nice or is this beautiful? Hey, look at that. Wow. So the Note 2 and the Note 3 here in the house, they have the same look and feels, and they run the same ROM effect. Only this ROM was mod, and this one was already effect prepared. So this ROM is a prepared ROM, has everything in it. This one, in fact, must be flashed with the mod to get these look and feels, and then yeah, you're good to go. So, yeah, if you have the Note 2 or you don't have it, it doesn't matter. You can still get these looks thanks to the mod. I will share them both, don't worry.
Now, both of the phones are now having the same look and feels. I think it's as well a nice toy for you to play with again. So if you liked this, you know what you saw in this video, even though the video was a bit long, leave this video a thumbs up and try it out. Check out links in the description. You will find the ROM and the mod on my Android file host. So go check it out, peeps. Yeah, that's it for this video. Hope you enjoyed it. I'm gonna play with the Note 2 and the Note 3 a bit and see if they work good. And of course, you can as well let me know if it all worked for you out there. And as well, let me know the phones that you install this onto, the mod at least, you know, and if the applications are satisfying. That was it. So thank you again for watching. Have a fine evening, peeps. And then you will see me in the next video tomorrow again.